And now we go to the new step. It's already step of shipment. Here, my main message is, even though, you know, all of your quality, all of your inspection has passed and all of your products might be perfect quality, there still can be something wrong done during the shipment and on the shipment stage. And your product can be damaged. And why it can be so? It can be due to the poor packaging and loading process and to the poor container performance and condition. Some example is sometimes, you know, the containers can have holes in them. So when your products are actually traveling through the ocean, it can be raining, you know, and salt water can go inside of the container and then can go inside of your cartons, and your product can be damaged. That's why it's important to check the quality of the container, and also it's important to check the loading of your cartons, because sometimes factories are not loading the cartons how they should be loaded. You know, they're not putting the higher weight cartons below and lighter weight cartons above. Later, I'll show you the map of the container so you could have an understanding of how it looks like. And also, I heard some stories about the people who actually received not the products that they wanted. There was one guy from Brazil. He ordered some chemicals from China, and he didn't have inspection done. So, but their supplier took some pictures. So when the container was loaded, they took the pictures of the container weight and they showed it to the customer, and they said, "Hey, look, your container is ready and your container is going." But when he received the product inside, it was not chemicals, it was sand. And you understand that the customer paid for the chemicals, but he actually received the sand, and the factory was saying that they sent the product that actually was the chemicals, and something went wrong during the shipment process, and they actually really shipped the chemicals, because look here, there is a weight numbers, and we told you that we shipped. So because of situations like this, it's also recommended to conduct the container loading supervision. And I'll just quickly show you what it includes. It includes the quantity of the product, product conformity, just to make sure that, you know, this is your product going to be shipped, and not sand instead of chemicals. Also, there's going to be packing and marking check, loading process, and any of your special requirements. So we will actually send our inspector to your factory during the loading date, and we'll ask the inspector to supervise your product loading. Your product will be loaded according to the special techniques, and the inspector will supervise every part of the loading, so 1/4, 1/2, 3/4, and the full container. And he will also draw a map of your product, so you will understand what item is placed where, and whether everything is securely placed inside of the container. Also, after the container is loaded, our inspector will put our own seal, V-Trust seal, on the container. So it will be already sealed, and the factory cannot change anything inside there before the container leaves. So when you receive the container there and you see V-Trust seal there, not open, it means that, you know, the products were, and the container was not open during this process. And the goods are the same as they were leaving the factory. Yeah, but if you see that the seal was open, then you can already talk to your shipping agent and try to understand what was there, whether there was custom check of your container. And you need to make sure that all the products that were shipped from the factory are actually inside of the container. So this is basically it. My presentation is finished. Sorry for keeping you for so long.
That was really great information. I learned so much. I have never actually gone through the full reports for everything and seen all of those examples. So it is really great to get an understanding of all of the things I think it's good to get an understanding of the reasons that we should consider various things. Even the shipment inspection, I haven't ever seen anyone do one of those. And now after seeing the report and what is checked out, it makes complete sense why you would want to do that.